if you're just learning to program or even a professional programmer, up until about 2020, 2021, you've likely visited Stack Overflow many, many times. Now, you might not have actually gone to the website and went through their search tool, but it was very likely that if you went and searched for some issue on Google or Bing or whatever search engine you happen to use, around that time, if it was programming related, you're probably going to end up on this site, because for a lot of questions, that was the best resource to go to. It was so prolific, in fact, that people had this idea that if Stack Overflow ever went down, developer productivity would crawl to a halt. Now, do I think there is some truth to that? There's definitely some truth to that, that's for sure. Do I think all of it? No, that was kind of a meme. But people did ask, like, hey, what would happen if Stack Overflow went down on places like Quora? And people genuinely, you know, were concerned about the platform going away. But at least for the past couple of years, you probably haven't heard anyone really talking about it. Yeah, it comes up from time to time. Yeah, there's a meme about it here and there. But instead, now it's something like, if ChatGPT goes down, or Grok, or Gemini, or insert your favorite AI tool, if that goes down, developer productivity crawls to a halt. And this isn't just, like, a vibe thing. It's not just the fact that Stack Overflow's been around for a very long time, and Stack Overflow just isn't cool to talk about anymore, but it's still something that a lot of people actually use. The site is cooked. The site is done. Like, Stack Overflow is dead. It has the legacy data, but no one uses it for new stuff anymore. Honestly, I have no idea how they could possibly recover from this, let alone the fact that a lot of people, I don't think, actually want them to recover. So by 2013, this is questions per month. We're seeing about 150,000, 160,000 to about 170,000 per month. And this was trending really quickly upwards over those first couple of years. The peak was in 2014 with 207,000 questions per month. Then for some reason it kind of dipped off, not really sure what happened there, but it mostly kind of leveled out, jumping up and down between those two points for the next couple of years. Then from about mid-2017, it began trending downwards. Then obviously we all know what happened. This was lockdowns, this was COVID. People started working from home, and honestly, I think the reason why it spiked up then is people couldn't just go and ask their co-workers a question because they were likely not working in the office with them, so people went back to the thing they knew, and people started asking questions again. But after that was kind of the death of Stack Overflow. There was a little jump up here, and then it just crashed down into the ground, and now we are seeing, let's go to the previous month, 3,862 questions. This is about as much as they had a month after starting. But I don't think this was just one singular event. We can very clearly see three different points that began to fall. This point right here, this point here, and then something happened which just crashed it into the ground. This is not the same thing that caused this, or at least not entirely. I think it's pretty clear what put the final nail in the coffin and filled the hole. AI, LLMs. At this point here, back in 2021, we're starting to see some of the early AI tools. They weren't great, they weren't amazing, but they did exist, right? People were trying them out, and you weren't getting great answers for a lot of things, but you were getting something. And that, for a lot of people, was kind of good enough to play around with, but as you can see, things still kind of kept up with just a slow creep downwards. This point here, though, this is about the end of things, because late 2022 is when we saw the launch of ChatGPT. And whilst it wasn't great, whilst it hallucinated a lot of things, it was much better than anything people had used before. And you might want to talk about hallucinations now, but go back and look at what things were like then. They were so much worse. This killed Stack Overflow. Like, it just dropped basically overnight. And from there, things have only gotten better and better and better. And, well, as you can see, no one even, like, there's a few comments, a few questions, but barely anyone uses it anymore. And even though it did suck at the time, even though it wasn't great, what it did mean is you didn't have to deal with Stack Overflow. And I think Stack Overflow is a big part of the reason why Stack Overflow died. Yes, AI was a very big deal, but people still use Reddit. People still use other platforms. It is what Stack Overflow provided, the culture around Stack Overflow, that I think is what ultimately is killing the platform. Because as you saw, Stack Overflow didn't begin dying here. It began dying here. Back in 2017, we didn't have AI tooling yet. That wasn't a thing yet. Conceptually existed since the 90s, but not something that people were publicly using. But it was already going down, and the only thing that brought it back up was the fact that people had to stay home. One of the top search results on basically every search engine is why Stack Overflow is toxic. And you're going to find tons and tons of threads of people talking about their experience. Now, when I'm talking about the toxicity of Stack Overflow, I don't mean it as in, oh, they hurt my feelings. They said some mean words to me. This is unpleasant. Of course, you're gonna get some of that because you're on the internet, and that's what you get on the internet. What I mean by toxicity is if you're someone who is not established on the platform and you go and ask a question, the platform is effectively unusable due to the environment built up inside of it. So here's what typically happens on Stack Overflow. Best case scenario, you have a new account, you have no reputation on the platform, you ask a question, and you're not really sure how to ask it because, you know, you're maybe not an experienced developer, you're not great at forming a question because knowing how to form a question and knowing how to answer a question and knowing the thing you want to solve are all very different skills. And you don't just naturally get them by, you know, being a developer. But best case scenario, nothing happens. You post a question and nobody responds. Maybe it gets a couple of views, but you're kind of just sitting there for a couple of hours having no answer whatsoever. By the time you maybe get an answer, you probably found the answer somewhere else and don't even care what's on Stack Overflow anymore. Option number two is your post gets flooded with reports because it's a badly formed question. Your question may be a duplicate of another one when it's actually not. Your question gets downvoted and then marked as off topic. You know, like this one here. This was posted today. Posted about 9 hours ago. It's been locked as a bunch of downvotes and is never actually going to be answered. This is a lot of questions on the platform. Now, not all of them, okay? Okay, fine. A lot of them, this is active. Let's go to newest. A lot of them, this is another one. Let's see, is this one, it's been downvoted. It has some answers. Wow, that's better than most. A lot of them now are gonna be like this. There's just gonna be nothing on, another one's been downvoted. A lot of them are just gonna have nothing. It's a wasteland. And ultimately, when it's a case like this one, you don't really know what you've done wrong because this is a totally legitimate question to ask, and you're probably just not gonna come back to the platform. And the problem we start seeing all this is it basically creates a death spiral. This is a spiral that you basically cannot recover from. It is the same as the MMO death spiral. Because when people see questions are not being answered, people are not going to ask questions. When people are not asking questions, there's going to be less people on the platform to answer questions. When there are less people on the platform to answer questions, there's less questions that are going to be answered. When less questions are going to be answered, less people are asking questions, and it spirals out of control. Now, over on Stack Exchange, there have been these questions about the toxicity of the Stack Overflow, Stack Exchange environment. And from user data, people say the thing they find most frustrating or unappealing about Stack Overflow is the unwelcoming community. And not everyone, right? There are absolutely people that answer questions nicely, that do things great. but the replies under this tell you exactly what you need to know. To sum it up, everything that prevents users from getting their answer for free is considered as toxic by them. They want your time for free and our rules don't matter to them. So answer or be called toxic. That word has been thrown around so much that it almost has no meaning behind it. People think Stack Overflow is a support desk, and because their needs are not met, they deem the site to be toxic or unsatisfactory. It's a fundamental failing by Stack Exchange to communicate clearly to new users about what this site is not. At this point, toxic is that which goes against me. And sure, there is absolutely some merit to these perspectives being had. But ultimately, to a newcomer to the platform who sees, oh, I want to ask a question, it's opinion-based, it gets closed. It's a duplicate, gets closed. It's off-topic, gets closed. It gets an answer, and then it's something like, oh, you don't understand the question you're asking, reform the question, and it's just, in many ways, to new people, it comes off as this, like, air of elitism. And if you don't need to come to this platform, if there's another option available, those other options start to feel very appealing. Again, it was not every single person answering questions. There are absolutely people, maybe this is a bad example, this is about AI. Let's go to another one. There are absolutely people that are offering good answers, good advice, well-formed, everything you need. But there is enough people that have this sort of, I'm better than you, this is how we do things here, that it kind of flavors the whole platform. It doesn't really matter that there are good people on the platform answering questions in a nice way when the person you're dealing with right now is kind of an ass and your question's not being answered and you don't know why your question's not being answered and it's not just general users of the platform. It seems like platform moderation also kind of leans in this direction as well and encourages this kind of, you know, we're better than you mentality. And early on, that absolutely worked because this was a central hub to get your questions answered. But then things like Reddit started getting popular. And yes, there are absolutely bad communities on Reddit. And yes, there are bad communities on Reddit. But in many cases, that's just that community. You can go to the community right next to it, and it's a completely different vibe, and people are willing to answer questions. If you're asking a bad question, people will help you clarify. And there's not this encouragement to make things this, like, perfectly crystal clear question. People are willing to have a discussion about it. And then in 2015, Discord came along. And yeah, Discord is primarily focused on gamers, but nowadays it has this forum feature in it, and you can just use it as a way to ask questions. And for a lot of people, getting that, like, quick back and forth is really valuable for them. They don't really need a perfectly well-curated answer. They kind of just want to know something and have some sort of dialogue about the thing they're trying to solve. And this is not just me saying this. The numbers show that. People were already leaving Stack Overflow long before AI because other platforms just had kind of a very different vibe to them. Stack Overflow was very highly optimized around well-curated answers, well-curated questions, and ranking highly in Google SEO. But for the user, for the person asking the question, that didn't create a platform that was pleasant. That didn't create a platform where you felt like you would actually get your question answered. If you were just searching through Google for a question that had already been answered, it was a great resource. But for someone new, like, why would you go and ask a question there? And nowadays you have this AI tooling just, in many cases, a click away. It's built right into your search engine. There are AI chatbots. There are AI plugins for your browser. It's very likely for a lot of the, like, modern editors, there's probably AI built into the editor or there's an AI plugin for it. And if you're someone who wants to use these tools, like, it's right there. Now, you can say, oh, these tools don't provide you a good answer. There's going to be a better answer with somebody who deeply understands the topic. And yeah, in many cases, you're absolutely going to be right. And for many areas, there's not incredible coverage for these tools, but they provide you an answer. And if the answer is wrong, you can ask again. You can clarify. You can provide a code example and get the AI to help you. All of this happens in less time than it takes to get your question locked with no answer on Stack Overflow. So, like, again, why would you go and use it instead? And it's funny because a lot of people are very angry about AI destroying many things out there, and rightfully they are angry. But when it comes to Stack Overflow, most people I've seen are kind of just celebrating because they didn't like Stack Overflow to begin with. But do you know who is celebrating the most? And they're not going to do it publicly, but I'm sure in private there's lots of people celebrating. That being the founders and everybody else involved in Stack Overflow before it got purchased in 2021, about 5 months before ChatGPT came out, for $1.8 billion. About a year and a half before ChatGPT came out, and the platform plummeted into the ground. What a great deal that was. The question now becomes, what, if any, effect is this going to have on any future information in these LLM tools? Because obviously, they were trained on information that came from Stack Overflow, right? Like, that's, if it's on the internet, it's probably in an AI dataset. Stack Overflow offered clearly labeled questions and answers, and this no longer exists on any future tech. Other platforms obviously exist, and they're going to have their own training data, and there are docs and all of this stuff, but only time will tell. Like, a whole new language that doesn't have any sort of basis in any of the other languages that exist. I will be very curious to see where reasoning by these tools actually gets to by then. But hey, what do you think about the death of Stack Overflow? This is something people have been talking about for a while, but the graph that I showed you got some attention over on Hacker News recently, and everyone's been talking about it, so I'm talking about it as well. That's what we do here. Anyway, let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know any of the experiences you might have had with Stack Overflow as someone asking questions or even answering questions. I'd love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Stally Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and what a time. What is this?